We are going to discuss about computer graphics laboratory, and the subject code is 15CSL68. The students can refer the textbook Computer Graphics with OpenGL version, 3rd edition, Pearson, written by Herne Baker, and you can also refer Edward Angel. So to understand the lab program, I'm going to explain some basics. So these are the basics of OpenGL. The first point is, OpenGL is hardware independent interface. So you can write a program in any language using C or C++ or Java, and you don't think about the output device, how to draw the graphics in that output device. So the program is applicable on any output device. So that's why it is hardware independent. Second one, OpenGL is using all the callback functions. So we don't directly write code inside main. We'll use callback functions. Inside callback functions, we'll write command. Third one is, we are going to use a command called glut main loop. So it keeps the loop, main, under a loop. So all the callback functions are under loop till you close the program. And OpenGL is case sensitive. It is camel case. Camel case means first letter will be small letter, the next word, beginning of each word will be caps. So before starting OpenGL, you should understand these three library. One is GL, graphics library, GLU, graphics library utilities, and graphics library utility toolkit. So many GL functions you may see later in the program. So these functions are called low level functions. So creating vertex, matrix manipulation, all those functions will start with GL. Then GLU. So we are going to see some GLU functions. Those functions will be used for shapes and transformations. And other functions, glut functions, are high level functions. So mostly in the main, we'll use most of the glut functions. What you should do to write a program? So in the lab, what is our job? So these are the three points you remember. The first two is compulsory, the last is optional. First one is, if you want to draw something, a line or point, how the line or point should be viewed. So that location parameter of camera should be specified. For this, in our lab program, we'll use this command, either GLU ortho 2D or GL ortho. Second point is, whatever you are planning to draw a line or a polygon or a cube, so that algorithm will be written. And you can specify light operations by using these functions, but it is not compulsory, optional. We'll see these functions later in few of the lab program. So every OpenGL lab program will have these three basic functions: main, init, and display. Let us see the function one by one. Now main. Almost all the main functions will have this command. So if you understand this command, the rest of the program, the same command will be used. So all the program will have this command first, glut init, argument C, argument V. So this command is initializing your glut library with C or C++. And you know the first line, this command is a glut command, and this is a command line argument in C. So this is initializing your glut library. And the second command is glut init display mode. So it is initializing your display, your output mode. So how the output should come? So these are the two by default we'll use. Glut single. Glut single means the output is coming only one time to the display device. This is called single buffering. down, you can read the comment. Only one frame buffer used to draw and display the content. The second option is we are going to use RGB color model. Now we can see the third command, glut init window size. We are initializing the window size 500 pixel, that is initial window. Later we can resize the window. And the next command is glut init window position 00. When you run the program first time, where exactly the output window should come, that is top left corner. So 00 is the top left corner. Students can change any value here. The next one is glut create window, that is creating your output window. So on those window, we can see our output. And there is a word, this is my first program. So that is a title bar. That title will be displayed in your output window. Next is my init. This is one user defined function. Some initialization part will do. So later we'll see this function. And glut display function display. Here display is a user defined function. Display is a user defined function. Glut display func is the syntax to call display. So whatever you want to draw, line, points, cube, that coding can be written inside display. And the next one is glut main loop. It keeps the main under a loop. So you can see the command, it keeps on calling continuously all the display function. So whatever is written inside main, it is continuously called till you close the output window. We'll see the next function, myInit. So myInit, the first command, we are clearing the color buffer. So every time the output is keep on changing. Changing means if you draw a line, if you resize the window, a new line will come. So what happened to the previous line? So that color of the line, it should be cleared. So the first command gl clear will clear the buffer, color buffer. And the next gl clear color 00001. So that is the background color. Here 000 means black color. The last one is alpha color. What is alpha color? It is combining your output with the background. For example, if you see any line, the viewer is looking at the line. So which color is filled between viewer and the output? So we have mentioned here alpha color. It is one means full transparency. And we are, if in a 2D function, that it does not make any difference if you give 1 or 0. And the next one is GL matrix mode, GL underscore projection. GL matrix mode. Now in OpenGL, we are going to draw some image. We are going to edit, we are going to rotate. So if you want to do any operation with the image, it must be stored in a matrix format. So that's why it is GL matrix mode. What is this GL projection? GL projection is a 4x4 matrix. It keeps your output in the projection manner. So we know about projection. There will be a light source. Projectors are passed on the model. Then the model will be projected onto the screen. So based on this GL projection technique, this matrix is created and the image information is stored in a matrix format. You can read the comment. It is a 4x4 matrix. So whatever the operation, apply subsequent matrix operation to the projection matrix. If you translate the image, if you modify the image, if you edit the image, all this transformation will be keep on adding with GL projection matrix. And the last command is GLU ortho2D. That is a viewing function. Ortho means it is 90 degree. So this command is giving a parallel view, a 2D parallel view. 0500 0500. So let us see the next slide. So you can understand there is a left, right, bottom, top. So left side, it was mentioned 0, right side 500, and bottom also 0, top is 500. So we are covering only the positive area. If you draw any line, so the line will be drawn only in this positive area. So it is mentioned in the command 0500, 0500. If you change, instead of 0, you can mention minus 500. So the full viewing area will be covered. So without changing the line, it will look small. So I have drawn a view volume here. So this is applicable for 3D. You can understand left, right, bottom, top. The third function in every program will be display. So void display, this function was called from main glut display func my display. So you can use your line drawing logic by writing a separate function here. And the last line of display will be glflush. Glflush is the command will take your output to the display. Means it is flushing out the output from your frame buffer to display. We'll see one sample program. You can see the main. So the main is having all the command what we have explained. Students can understand. So in this first we are calling myInit. So myInit will come here. So all these four line will be written for every program. And after myInit, display function calling display. So to draw a line. So again from line drawing, we are passing the control to the line drawing. So this function line drawing will draw a line for the given x1, y1 to x2, y2. You can see the last line of the main. Before return, it is glut main loop. So the main is continuously running under a loop. And you can see the output right hand side. A line has been drawn for the given program.